Linda Archer. I work for McDonald's in Times Square on 42nd Street. I am a minimum wage worker as a cashier, and I am without benefits.
Hi, my name is Kimberly Ortiz. I am 27 years old, and I am a low wage worker. I worked at the Statue of Liberty for about 5 years total, and even with the assistant manager position, I was only getting $9.75 at this job.
My name is Nadir Omo, and I've been working at Target since about 2009, and I started off making $8.25, which was just a quarter above minimum wage.
It's very difficult because there's so much pressure, and this is a major industry.
Some weeks I would work 20 hours, some weeks I would work 30 hours, but it wasn't enough to make ends meet.
Sometimes I went without one or the other, either rent, no food, food, no rent.
New York City is already spending billions of dollars a year in a variety of subsidy programs in the name of economic development and job creation. This means taxpayers are spending, you know, $2 billion a year, and what are they getting in return? What they're getting in return right now is mostly poverty-level jobs. The living wage ordinance is a way to kind of get around that, to encourage the city to use its money wisely.
If we're going to put our tax dollars into a project, it should yield wages that people can live by. We shouldn't be pushing people into poverty using the dollars that you and I pay every single day.
This living wage from 10 to 11, $11.50, is what's needed to be a person who can sustain a family in the city of New York.
If we pass the living wage bill in the city of New York, the vast majority of individuals will no longer have to rely upon food stamps, on public assistance, on the dole of the city of New York.
Providing a living wage and reasonable benefits to those folks that are doing hard work day in and day out supporting their families is really just part of the social contract that we have in the city of New York.
A living wage would change my life drastically because I have two small children who I could better provide for.
It will help me as far as education, my educational expenses, affordable housing, self-sufficiency, and would guarantee me 10 plus, and I wouldn't have to worry.
Please join us on November 21st to tell the city that now is the time to pass the Fair Wages for New Yorkers Act.
Also, come out to the hearing on the living wage on November 22nd. We worked really hard to come this far. We want to make sure we get to the finish line, and we need you to be there.